दिस द ग्रीन कलर ऑल ओवर द वॉटर बॉडी इज नथिंग बट द एल्गल ब्लूम, ओके, और यूट्रोफिकेशन. द कंसेप्ट इज कॉल्ड द यूट्रोफिकेशन. So, in this, you have the introduction, mechanism, process, stages, causes and sources, consequences, impacts, and how you can manage this eutrophication. So, what does eutrophication actually mean? The word trophy, okay, eutrophication mein jo trophy word hai, in Greek, it means food or nutrients, whereas the words oligo, meso, that is eutrophication, the eu and hyper stand for respectively for rare, moderate, abundant and excessive. Therefore, the word oligotrophic, mesotrophic, eutrophic and hypertrophic, which have been used by biologists to describe the various nutritional statuses of a marine or freshwater environment. In the sense, क्या है ये algal bloom क्यों होता है कि यहाँ पे जो लिखा है ना ट्रॉफी इन द सेंस या यूट्रोफिकेशन हम लोग जो बोलते हैं तो उसका जो हाफ वर्ड है ट्रॉफिकेशन वगैरह दैट इज एक्सेस ऑफ न्यूट्रिएंट्स व्हेन वाटर हैज एक्सेस ऑफ न्यूट्रिएंट्स बिकॉज दिस एल्गे इज नथिंग बट द माइक्रोस्कोपिक प्लांट्स राइट. तो एज यू नो द माइक्रोस्कोपिक प्लांट्स रिक्वायर दिस थिंग नाइट्रोजन एंड फॉस्फरस आर द थिंग्स दे रिक्वायर फॉर ग्रोथ राइट. जब भी हम लोग फर्टिलाइजर भी बोलते हैं कोई प्लांट्स के लिए यूज कर रहे हैं तो उसमें नाइट्रोजन फॉस्फरस एनपीके हम लोग बोलते थे ना तो दोज आर प्रेजेंट. सो लाइकवाइज इफ देर आर एक्सेस ऑफ न्यूट्रिएंट्स इन द वाटर मेनली नाइट्रोजन एंड फॉस्फरस विच आर रेस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द ग्रोथ ऑफ प्लांट्स एंड एल्गे इज नथिंग बट द माइक्रोस्कोपिक प्लांट. सो वेन देर इज एक्सेस ग्रोथ ऑफ एक्सेस अमाउंट ऑफ न्यूट्रिएंट्स इन द सर्फेस वाटर सोर्स इट गिव्स राइज टू यूट्रोफिकेशन और एल्गल ब्लूम एक्सेसिव ग्रोथ ऑफ एल्गे. ओके सो दिस यूट्रोफिकेशन मीन्स यू लिखा ना यू मीन्स अबंडेंट एंड ट्रॉफी मीन्स न्यूट्रिएंट दैट इज अबंडेंट ऑफ द न्यूट्रिएंट्स प्रेजेंट इन द वाटर. Therefore, the words oligotrophic, mesotrophic, eutrophic, and hypertrophic have been used by biologists to describe the various nutritional statuses of marine or freshwater environment. Barabar? These words are used to describe the potentially available biomass, that is, amount of organisms present in it. Okay. Then, जैसे बोला oligotrophic, mesotrophic, eutrophic on scale. High nutrients increase algal growth and decrease in the water clarity. Obviously, the water completely turns green in color. What clarity will it have? Okay. So, depending upon those words, we have oligotrophic lake, mesotrophic lake, eutrophic lake, and hypertrophic lake. Bolte. Now, this eutrophic lake, matlab eutrophication, jahan pe hota hai, wahan pe you see more number of the algal bloom. Isliye the eutrophication word has come from this. So, when you say oligotrophic, that is the lake is low in nutrients, productivity is low, and many species are there, low population and nice clean water. Okay, in the sense, nutrients usme kam hai. Productivity is low, that is increase in the algae which serves on these nutrients is low. Many species in the sense, the aquatic life, that is fishes and all, those are actually present. Low population of the algae and it is nice clean water, that is oligotrophic. When you talk about mesotrophic lake, this is intermediate level of nutrients. Plankton is intermediate. Plankton matlab मैंने मुझे मुझे लगता है लास्ट टाइम बोला था ये जू प्लैंकटॉन फाइटो प्लैंकटॉन प्लैंकटॉन आर नथिंग बट स्मॉल. हाँ मैंने बायोलॉजी के कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स में बताया था दैट इज स्मॉल माइक्रो नॉट माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म बट स्मॉल ऑर्गेनिजम्स ऑफ यू नो एक्वेटिक लाइफ जैसे स्मॉल फिशेस वगैरह अगर बोलते हैं दैट इज कॉल्ड द जू प्लैंकटॉन. व्हेन स्मॉल प्लांट्स व्हेन वी से दैट इज कॉल्ड द फाइटो प्लैंकटॉन. सो इट इज इंटरमीडिएट सम ऑर्गेनिक सेडिमेंट एंड मॉडरेटली clear water. When you talk about eutrophic lake, it is rich in nutrients, low transparency, high plankton. Just like I said, small, this thing, very small plants. Okay, phytoplankton. Yeah, high plankton. यहाँ पे अगर वो बोल रहे हैं in the sense both phytoplankton as well as zooplankton. So यहाँ पे अगर phytoplankton बोलते हैं मतलब high plankton में high phytoplankton मतलब high amount of algae. because algae is also a type of phytoplankton, right? Small size of the plants. And also जैसे तुम्हारे वाटर का क्वालिटी खराब होने लग जाता है, जू प्लैंकटॉन भी उसमें आने लग जाते हैं. यूजुअली वी वुड सी फ्रेश वाटर, यू नो, दिस थिंग फिशेस, बट देखो तुम गटर के बारे में भी देखो, यू विल सी स्मॉल स्मॉल फिशेस लाइक थिंग्स. तो दोज आर नथिंग बट, और वर्म्स लाइक थिंग्स, दोज आर नथिंग बट दी जू प्लैंकटॉन विच लिव इन वाटर. So that they arise when the water quality has decreased. Okay, see, showing increase in the signs of water quality problems. And hypertrophic is very high nutrient concentration where plant growth is determined by physical factors. Water quality problems are serious and almost continuous. Okay. So eutrophication is an accelerated growth of algae on higher forms of plant life. Okay. Caused by the enrichment of water by nutrients, especially compounds of nitrogen and or phosphorus, and inducing undesirable disturbance to the balance of organisms present in the water and the quality of the water concerned. अभी इसका मीनिंग, अभी जैसे हम लोग अगर बोलते हैं कि न्यूट्रिएंट्स उसमें बढ़ रहे हैं वाटर में, तो हम लोग क्या बोलेंगे, न्यूट्रिएंट्स बढ़े तो पानी अच्छा है ना. इट्स नॉट लाइक दैट, बिकॉज दिस न्यूट्रिएंट्स गिव राइज टू दिस स्मॉल प्लांट्स विच इज समथिंग the algae in eutrophication concept. So which is actually not accepted, that forming a complete, kyunki the aquatic system is full of the even the plants and even the animals, right? So there becomes a disturbance, there is too much increase in the algae, which then reduces the, which then affects the other organisms in the water. Okay, then human caused and accelerated eutrophication is referred as cultural eutrophication, human caused or accelerated eutrophication. In the sense, ये जो excess of nutrients in water है, ये आता कहाँ से है? So it is the man-made utilities or man-made things, जिसमें से ये सब this thing nutrients come into this surface water sources, like. See, cultural eutrophication, यहाँ पे उन्होंने डायग्राम में बताया, when there was no development, okay, when there was original, this lake was like the original, in its original, this body, so there was no, and there was no development, so you could see the fishes and everything, even the plants you could see, right, all these things were there, natural system of the lake, but then when there was such a development all over, from the habitation, from the industrial areas, everything, and when then the wastewater from those areas, when that was let down in this particular lake, obviously that wastewater contains or sewage contains nutrients and phosphorus along with other toxic compounds. It also contains nutrients and phosphorus also. So ye agar nutrients tum isme sewage dal rahe ho, iska matlab usme tum nutrients and phosphorus jo algal bloom ke liye zarurat hai uska bhi amount jo hai wo increase kar rahe ho. So when that increases, so as you see the deposition jo sediment tha wo bhi increase ho gaya kyunki tumne usme sewage dala hai, and plus because of the nitrogen phosphorus content you could see the lake has turned green in color. There is no fish life, only this green is nothing but the algal bloom. Okay, the mechanism that lead to eutrophication, that is to this new status of aquatic environment, are complex and interlinked. The main cause of eutrophication is the large input of the nutrients to a water body, and the main effect is the imbalance in the food web that results in high level of phytoplankton biomass in stratified water bodies. This can lead to algal bloom. Okay, so that is when only one thing that is in excess, that is algae, but then it has affected the other things. Okay, so then ultimately the food web in the aquatic system is disturbed, is in the im it is imbalanced. Causes of eutrophication and supporting factors. The enrichment of water by nutrients can be of natural origin, but it is often dramatically increased by human activities. This occurs almost everywhere in the world. Main sources of nutrient input are, so where does this nitrogen phosphorus ye aa kaise rahe hai in that particular surface water source? Either from runoff, okay, erosion and leaching from fertilized agriculture areas. You know, agriculture areas will be full of this nitrogen and phosphorus. Agar waha pe erosion and leaching hai and that runoff, that water is coming and joining this lake, then again there is increase in the nutrients. Sewage from the cities and industrial wastewater, if that is also getting mixed into it. Atmospheric deposition of nitrogen from animal breeding and combustion gases, that is also one of the reason. Then other point and non-point sources. Point and non-point matlab direct and indirect. Direct, jo tumar isme, I mean the direct source let into the surface water source or some indirect source. Okay. So these are the reasons sources of nutrient increase in the water. So yehi unhone sources yahan pe bataya hai. I don't know if it is visible properly. So this is discharge of treated municipal sewage into the water, dissolving of the nitrogen oxides from internal combustion engine and furnace, runoff from streets, lawns, construction areas, runoff and erosion from cultivation, mining areas. Then manual runoff from the feed, I don't know, feed something is written. Okay, feedstock, I think. Then natural runoff, then nitrogen compounds by cars, okay, and discharge of the detergents, discharge of the untreated municipal sewage. So these are the various factors when pollution or any wastewater is increased in this particular surface water source. Along with this wastewater, the main nitrogen and phosphorus nutrients are going to enhance this algal growth. So what is the main consequence of eutrophication? What happens is, you know, I have already told you that dissolved oxygen is very important thing in any water source. All the aquatic life, the aquatic plants are dependent upon the dissolved oxygen present in the water. Now what happens is, when in the algal bloom, that the surface of the water becomes full of algae, becomes completely green in color, okay, and the surface source that is green in color because it is absorbing using the sunlight from the atmosphere. But what happens is, the bottom layer, bottom to this algal layer, those layers become deficit in the oxygen. They don't get the oxygen because the above layer is like a closed lid. Ek lid ban jata hai wo lake ka. So nothing could enter into the lakes. That is, dissolved oxygen cannot enter into the lake. And that is why the fishes and the other aquatic plants that survive inside that aquatic system, then that they do not survive. So whenever you see a particular lake or a river which is full of this eutrophication, that is full of this green color, obviously it's not like that only the green color part, that is only the surface is contaminated. The complete river or the complete water surface source is contaminated, because then there is lack of oxygen. Because there is lack of oxygen, there is no originality of the, what you say, aquatic condition. There is no fish life and there is no plants, because the oxygen level had decreased at the bottom of the layer. So main consequence of the eutrophication, that is availability of oxygen, low volume of oxygen due to microbial decomposition, respiration, and all life will disappear. Very specific smell of rotten egg originating mainly from sulfur will appear. As I told you in the previous lecture also, sulfur, I mean the H2S, hydrogen sulfide, has this smell of the rotten eggs. So when this hydrogen sulfide gets the release in the anaerobic conditions, jaise agar upar ke layers mein eutrophication, that is algal bloom ho gaya hai, so niche ke layers mein obviously it is deprived of oxygen. So if it is deprived of oxygen, there is no fish life, there is no plant life inside it, and then there is growth of the anaerobic bacteria, and this anaerobic bacteria then give rise to gases like the methane, CO2 and H2S. Okay. Changes in the algal population, that is excessive growth of macroalgae, phytoplankton, cyanobacteria, algal bloom. Okay. That is original aquatic plants jo hone chahiye us particular source mein, those disappear, but then there are excessive growth of this algae, phytoplankton. Like algae, there are other like algae is also phytoplankton. Similar like algae, there are other microscopic plant lives. They also grow phytoplankton and then bacteria. Okay. Then changes in the zooplankton, that is decrease. This zooplankton, so maine tumko already bola, that is the aquatic animals. So decrease in the fish and shellfish population, invertebrate, etc. But here also, जूप्लैंकटन में जब द स्मॉल वेरी स्मॉल फिशेस और विच सर्वाइव इन द एनएरोबिक नॉट एनएरोबिक बट दिस विच सर्वाइव विथ लेस अमाउंट ऑफ ऑक्सीजन ऑल्सो दे कुड बी सीन मेनी टाइम्स इन दैट पोल्यूटेड वाटर. डायरेक्ट कॉन्सिक्वेंस इज एन एक्सेस ऑफ ऑक्सीजन कंजम्पशन नियर द बॉटम ऑफ द वॉटर बॉडी. द रेशियो ऑफ नाइट्रोजन टू फॉस्फरस कंपाउंड इन ए वॉटर बॉडी इज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट फैक्टर. डिटरमाइनिंग विच ऑफ द टू एलिमेंट्स विल बी द लिमिटिंग फैक्टर एंड कॉन्सिक्वेंटली विच वन हैज टू बी कंट्रोल इन ऑर्डर टू रिड्यूस द फ्लो. ओके, द रेशियो ऑफ नाइट्रोजन एंड फॉस्फरस. नाइट्रोजन फॉस्फरस में से लिमिटिंग फैक्टर आई मीन लिमिटिंग फैक्टर मतलब किसके ज्यादा किसका ज्यादा इम्पैक्ट हो रहा है. Which has limited the growth of the aquatic system. Okay, so इसमें से कौन सा ज्यादा impact करने वाला है? So that you are supposed to find out. Then generally phosphorus tends to be the limiting factor for phytoplankton in fresh water. Okay, that is the growth of the phytoplankton mostly happens because of the phosphorus compound. And large marine areas frequently have nitrogen as the limiting nutrient. Then this is your healthy system, जैसे मैं बोल रही थी original aquatic life and the eutrophic system. So you could see in the healthier system there are healthy bay grasses, balanced algae growth. Algae होता है क्योंकि उसमें algae होता ही नहीं, कोई भी माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म होता नहीं है वाटर में, ऐसा नहीं. इट इज देयर बट इन द बैलेंस कंडीशन, नॉट एक्सेसिव. देन यू हैव द हेल्दी सिस्टम, यू नो एक्वाटिक लाइफ, एडिक्वेट ऑक्सीजन. बट वेन यू टॉक अबाउट दिस यूट्रोफिक, सो हम लोग को क्या दिखता है? सिर्फ ऊपर का लेयर दिखता है, तो उसके नीचे क्या है? सो एल्गल ब्लूम, सिर्फ डॉटेड पार्ट. एक्सेसिव न्यूट्रिएंट्स, सो एक्सेसिव ग्रोथ ऑफ द एल्गे, राइट. रेड्यूस्ड बे ग्रास, दिस बे ग्रास बिकॉज देन एट द बॉटम लेयर दे आर नॉट गेटिंग द सनलाइट, दे आर नॉट गेटिंग द ऑक्सीजन. ओके, देन एल्गे, वेन देर इज एक्सेसिव ग्रोथ ऑफ एल्गे, बट देन only the surface layer survives because only the surface layer gets the oxygen and the sunlight. The bottom layer of the algae, that is algae die off and algae decomposition. Okay, no or low no oxygen. So इसमें क्या है? वही हो जाता है कि जो algae है, okay, only the surface layer it will survive because it requires sunlight, it requires oxygen. But the bottom layers of the algae will die. And then again at the bottom, what will happen is algae decomposition, anaerobic decomposition of the algae. Okay. And then low or no oxygen level. Then you see the aquatic life also. There is no such aquatic life present. So that is your eutrophic system. जैसे यहाँ पे बताया stages of eutrophication, spristae, I mean the start condition. Okay. Then start of eutrophication. And extreme eutrophication because there has been increase in the industrial areas and the habitation, which will then impart this the anoxic water, that is anaerobic water, which H2S bubbles. Factors supporting the development of eutrophication: time of renewal of water. टाइम ऑफ रिन्यूअल ऑफ वाटर मतलब ऐसा नहीं है कि हर बार कोई रिवर या लेक का पानी चेंज करते बैठते, लेकिन देर आर इफ देर आर यू नो ब्रांचेस ऑफ फ्रेश वाटर्स कनेक्टिंग टू दैट पर्टिकुलर रिवर और लेक, सो देर विल बी कंटिन्यूअस मिक्सिंग और डायल्यूशन ऑफ द पोल्यूटेड वाटर, राइट. इफ देर इज कंटिन्यूअस डायल्यूशन ऑफ द पोल्यूटेड वाटर विद द फ्रेश वॉटर, ऑब्वियसली दैट इज कॉल्ड द रिन्यूएबल और रिन्यूअल ऑफ वॉटर, सो दैट विल मेंटेन द वॉटर क्वालिटी. ओके, जियोलॉजिकल फीचर्स सच एज द शेप ऑफ द बॉटम ऑफ द वॉटर बॉडी, शेप नहीं लेकिन डेप्थ ऑफ द वॉटर बॉडी हम लोग बोल सकते हैं. ओके, बिकॉज द एनरोबिक कंडीशंस विल डिपेंड इन द एक्वेटिक सिस्टम विल डिपेंड अपॉन द डेप्थ ऑफ दैट वॉटर बॉडी. Then thermal stratification of stagnant water bodies, that is temperature changes along the layers of the water. The surface will have a different temperature, but then the temperature mostly goes on decreasing as you go at the bottom. But then again, because there is going on the decomposition process, temperature mostly increases. So there is changes in the temperature along the layers. So that also supports this eutrophication. Then temperature and light influence the development of aquatic algae. Obviously, algae requires temperature and light. Potential negative impacts of eutrophication क्या है? तो trophic status, हाँ, trophic अभी बताया था तुमको, that is trophic in the sense the nutrient status. Then ecological impact, economic impacts, human health impacts, recreational impacts and aesthetic impacts. So these are the impacts when you talk about eutrophication in a particular surface water source. Okay. So what are the ecological impacts? Macrophyte invasions impede. That is, this algae-like structures, macrophytes. Okay, the small organisms. Okay, but plant organisms. That is, they survive on this. That is phytoplankton, what you call. So they start increasing, but there is prevention of the other aquatic plants. Then only the more tolerant animal species can survive due to the algal bloom. Turbidity of the water increases. Release of cyanotoxins by cyanobacteria are recognized to have caused, because that bacteria is one of the bacteria which grows in number in eutrophication. So release of cyanotoxins by cyanobacteria are recognized to have caused the death of wild animals, farm livestock, pet, fish and birds in many countries. Decrease in the oxygen level can have a number of secondary water quality impacts. Then how do you manage or prevent this algal bloom? So this algal bloom you must have seen many areas, right? So for monitoring the eutrophication, to prevent the occurrence of the eutrophication, early warning purposes to the public health authorities to know the level of development of the process and have a precise picture of the quality of water, and research and multipurpose. That is how you can monitor, how you can go through and test, do the complete testing and quality of water timely to know the increase in the nutrient or other, you know, other impurities. Then parameters for monitoring the purposes are that is the what test of what all things you need to do when you are talking about eutrophication, that is nitrogen, phosphorus, to hai suspended solids, dissolved oxygen. Suspended solids because they get deposited, jaise wo lake mein dikhaya tha, it gets deposited at the bottom layers and the depth of the lake then decreases. Suspended solids, dissolved oxygen, bacteria, algae and cyanobacterial biomass, development of short living species of macrophytes. Then how you can prevent it, that is, just a second, catchment area of the water supply, identification of all the nutrient sources. Okay, that is the first prevention, identifying ki ye nutrient actually aa kahan se gaye into your water source. So the catchment area of the water supply, industrial activities, discharge practices and localization, best agricultural practices, that is fertilizer contribution, plant use and localization of crops, nature of the soil, vegetation and interaction between the soil and water. Okay, so these are the all things that you need to identify, that you need to know. Okay, so that is basically where is the nutrient coming from, what is the source of the nutrient, that you need to find, identify. Okay, so that is your identification of all the nutrient sources. The knowledge of the hydrodynamics, that is the way the nutrients are transported, and of the vulnerability of the aquifer. Okay, vulnerability of the aquifer matlab jaise maine tumko bola that aquifer is also water body, say. So if at all there is no dilution of the water, or there is complete always a stagnant of water, then that is more vulnerable to that particular layer of to that particular thing that the nutrients will be transported to that aquifer. Okay, so you are supposed to find and identify ki kaun sa aquifer, the underwater sources ki jahan pe ye nutrients transport ho sakte hain, and transport ho ke then wahan pe jo growth hone wala hai. So all these things you need to find out. So that comes under your prevention of the eutrophication. Then finding out the balance of nitrogen and phosphorus in the water, regular soil nutrient analysis, sufficient manure storage capacities, because कहीं से भी ये manure storage या soil से भी leach होके आना नहीं चाहिए. Okay, prevention of erosion on sloping soils, precise irrigation management and soil moisture control. So what happens is if the soil which is full of this nitrogen and phosphorus contents the agricultural soil and it is also moist, that water will start leaching into the underwater aquifers and then again it is going to increase the nutrients in that aquifers and then that way the nutrients can travel, right? Reuse and recycling of the water in aquaculture and agriculture, that is whatever the wastewater is generated in the aquaculture, matlab jahan pe fishes ka culture hum log karte hain aur agriculture, that wastewater should not be led into the into this the surface water source. Now what happens on kahi kahi pe to jahan pe sea hai wahan pe direct sea mein they deposit, but sea mein kya hota hai, it is lot of dilution happening, it is in the continuous movement and sea is very very huge, right? Thoda sa usme agar contamination ho bhi jata hai but it gets diluted, but when there is no source like sea, what happens is this bhale jo waste water generate ho raha hai ya the by product in the form of the waste water generated from the aquaculture agriculture bhale hi wo itna toxic nahi ho but usme jo hai nutrients and phosphorus excess amount mein hone wala hai. So agar aise soch ke rahe ki it is not that much polluted, so could be let into the surface water sources, but then it is going to increase the nutrient amount in that particular surface water sources. Therefore, maximum of reuse and recycling of water has to be done in aquaculture and agriculture.